If someone were to ask you what a rabid dog looks like, what would you say? The typical image conjured in the media is a deranged, manic creature foaming at the mouth. And although this can be the case, unfortunately, less obvious signs are far more common than most people realize. Actually, in the early stages of the disease, rabid dogs can look surprisingly normal and alert while they shed the world's deadliest virus in their saliva. Being aware of the clinical signs of rabies can be life-saving for anyone living in or visiting rabies endemic areas, and is especially critical for those working with animals. In this video, we're going to show you what to look out for in dogs and other animals using footage from Mission Rabies projects around the world. Rabies has a huge impact on the welfare of dogs, but the behaviors are caused by the rabies virus and not the dogs. So every biting dog is not rabid, and every rabid dog doesn't bite. Rabies in dogs is a disease which can be eliminated through mass dog vaccination. By knowing the signs of rabies, you'll be able to support efforts to control this disease and to protect yourself, your family, and your community. Some of the footage here is upsetting to watch, but it is the reality of this disease, affecting communities all over the world. We will be covering aspects of rabies control and post-exposure prophylaxis in detail in our other videos. Rabies can appear in either a furious form, characterized by hyperactivity, or a paralytic form, characterized by weakness and paralysis. But both forms rapidly progress to coma and death. The signs of rabies can vary hugely between animals, but the only consistent aspect in all cases is death, which always occurs within 10 days and most often within 4 days of the first signs of illness. As such, rabies should be considered in any animal which dies suddenly after a short illness in rabies endemic setting. The WHO considers a dog to be suspected of rabies if any of the following signs are present: hypersalivation, paralysis, lethargy, abnormal vocalization, and unprovoked abnormal aggression that could be biting two or more people or animals and inanimate objects. Let's go through the signs one by one. But remember, many rabid animals only show one or a few of these signs at any one time. The rabies virus can cause paralysis of the tongue and muscles of the throat. This can cause the tongue to hang loose, the jaw to hang open, and saliva to drool from the mouth. This saliva often contains high concentrations of the rabies virus. Here we can see the dog is unsteady on her feet, and you can see her tongue hanging loose. In this dog, you can also see the neurological signs of the dog twitching. Signs of weakness, slow movements, circular movements, and malcoordination are common in the paralytic presentation of rabies. Neurological signs of trembling, shaking, and convulsions are also common and are frequently mistaken for distemper. This can progress to seizure-like activity as seen in this dog. Some dogs with rabies can appear lethargic, as if they can't keep their eyes open, but then when stimulated, quickly become alert and aggressive once again. Other dogs are generally subdued and withdrawn, showing the signs more typical to the paralytic form of the disease. The rabies virus affects parts of the brain controlling primitive behaviors, and so a common sign of rabies is aggression. In dogs, this can result in an urge to bite objects, people, and animals around them, especially things that move. Dogs showing the furious form of rabies will often attack objects put near the cage or placed inside, as is shown in this footage of dogs later confirmed to have rabies. So it is especially important to handle these dogs with care, to make sure that the areas housing possible rabid dogs are clearly signposted and that all individuals with access are trained and vaccinated. As the virus affects the function of the muscles in the throat, there can be a change in the sound of the dog's bark with a strained or hoarse tone. The rabies virus really is a master of deception, and trying to paint a specific picture of what clinical rabies looks like in dogs will lead to missed cases, the signs of rabies between animals are consistently inconsistent. Some dogs are inappetent or unable to drink, while others continue to eat well. Some dogs appear even playful, while others are manic and aggressive. An indicative sign of rabies in people is a fear of water, or called hydrophobia. However, this sign is not observed in dogs, and so the idea that a dog that is still drinking is not rabid is a misconception. You have seen a number of puppies throughout this video. Rabies in puppies is often overlooked because biting and nipping is a normal behavior in healthy puppies. This can mean that people don't think of rabies after a bite or a scratch from a puppy, resulting in many human rabies deaths. Indeed, the risk of rabies in puppies has shown to be higher than in adult dogs in a number of studies, possibly because they are often missed during master vaccination campaigns or delayed being taken to a vet for vaccination, or simply because they are cute and cuddly, making chances of interaction with people higher. Bites and scratches from puppies should be managed in the same way as any other dog bite, and it is important that puppies of all ages get taken for vaccination during dog vaccination campaigns. The signs of rabies only get worse, never better. So in cases where the clinician is uncertain, monitoring the animal in quarantine will enable the trajectory of the disease to be assessed. Clinical signs invariably progress over a period of hours or days, as seen in this case, progressing to coma within 24 hours. Sadly, all dogs with rabies progress through to coma and death within 10 days of first showing signs, with no effective veterinary treatment currently known. The disease has a 100% mortality rate. Interesting to note that rabies is the only disease with 100% mortality rate, and so in cases where the animal is suffering, the kindest course of action is humane euthanasia to prevent a painful traumatic death. Dogs are the reservoir species for the rabies virus, and so transmission from dogs presents the greatest risk. However, any mammal can be infected with the rabies virus and has the potential to transmit the virus to people through its saliva. Most animals show the same spectrum of signs described for dogs. Both furious and paralytical forms have been reported in cats, cows, and other species. In the early stages of rabies surveillance programs, often cows are reported with signs of rabies, more often than dogs due to their close association with their owner. Rabies in cows is only the tip of the iceberg. So where there are rabies cases in cows, there is inevitably a large rabies reservoir population nearby. As for other animals, cows can exhibit the paralytic or furious form of rabies. Care should be taken when examining cows with hypersalivation, with many reports of people reaching into their mouths to check for an obstruction, but the animal turning out to have rabies. Cows with furious rabies can pose a considerable risk to communities due to their size and horns. We hope that one day the videos of these animals will serve only as a historical record of the disease. Rabies in dogs has been eliminated from many parts of the world through mass dog vaccination, but the disease still poses a very real threat to people across Africa and Asia. Mission Rabies is a charity working to develop methods and systems to support governments to implement effective dog vaccination campaigns on a huge scale, protecting not only the dogs from rabies, but also preventing the risk of this horrific disease to people. Click on the links below to find out more about their work and find out how you can support making ours the final rabies generation.